Hey, Thegrio fam, it's your girl, Natasha Alford.
And I'm Enitan Bereola II.
And we are your co-hosts for this special after show of the season finale of Love Is. What a great show. I just love this show so much.
Yes, yes. It's something that kind of like resonates with us all in this current generation. Something very necessary too.
Definitely. And I just feel like this show came out the gate on OWN. And it was, you know, a vision of Mara Brock Akil and Salim Akil. This is their true life love story. And yet it's brought back 90s nostalgia.
Yes.
You know, it's got people talking about relationships, family, not just romantic relationships. And so now that we've seen the season finale, we have to talk about it.
Let's do it. I've been waiting to talk about it, too. I've been mum the whole time. But I'm like, these are conversations I'm having in, like, group texts and amongst the friends and my wife, so I'm ready to like dig into it.
Absolutely. And if you are tuning in right now, make sure you hit us up in the comments with your reactions
Please.
To what we just saw on the season finale of Love Is, and we're going to throw some audience questions to you too. So let's just start with the first scene.
Yes.
Nuri and Yasir are at the kitchen table after one of the most intense nights ever.
Mm-hmm.
That scene, I mean, just going back to the last episode where they're crying and he's literally holding her in his arms was so emotional.
It was.
I feel like TV doesn't always go there, and I love that they talked about trauma and just like how even after all these years, it can still affect you.
Yeah, I think now we're in a time of vulnerability being in vogue. So people are talking about, you know, therapy, and we've taken the stigma off of it and realizing that like this is something that everybody deals with. You know, the fact that there's sexual abuse that goes on, there's trauma from parents, and there's just a lot of things that happen that we kind of continue to go through life and act like doesn't occur, you know what I mean? So it's a good scenario. It kind of put me in a position where I'm sort of uncomfortable.
Mm-hmm.
I could relate to some of it, and it was interesting how they dealt with the dynamic, how she shared her trauma, which then opened him up, which is actually a lesson, women, when you open up to us in that way, and you were vulnerable in that way, it gives us permission to be ourselves. When you give us permission to cry, to be ourselves, to respond in real ways, it opens up the can of worms, the gambit, so to speak.
Okay, so what do you think about the scene where Yasir tells Nuri that she's so orderly and kind of OCD, and really it's because she's going through trauma? Do you think he has a point?
Maybe, you know, I mean, he's trying to self-diagnose her, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I think that there is something to be said about people who have those kind of weird habits and those nuances that can translate back, but it could be a stretch. That could have been like a reach. I don't know.
Yeah, I love this moment where he's like, she's like, you know, you can talk to me. And he's like, isn't that what we're doing?
Yeah. And I think he has an issue. We'll get into it later with communication himself.